We got a cube and a cube stand and this nice little bag. Actually, I didn't really mean little because it's actually pretty tall, which is a little bit weird, but that's not what matters. Let's get into this cube. So as soon as it was announced, I pre-ordered the MS3 V1 cube. I think it was super interesting how it looks so much like a GAN cube, and we'll get into that a little bit more later. Let's just see what's in this box. Okay, so starting off with the accessories. Alright, so the first thing in here is a spare core and some extra parts for what I'm assuming is the spring compression system. Next up, we have the world's fattest springs. You also get a couple of extra logo stickers, which is nice. And finally, you get this pamphlet that I can't actually throw away this time because I might need it. Okay, so now that we got all the accessories out of the way, let's take a look at the cube. It's packed in there very tightly.
6 hours later.
Nice. As you can see, this cube has the purple logo, which means I got the enhanced version. Now, the only difference that makes is that it has 96 magnets, so it's a little bit more controllable. If you like faster cubes, then you shouldn't get this one. You should just stick with the standard one. Right out of the box, I'm noticing that it has a nice glossy finish, and I'm really happy they decided to do this because GAN's frosted plastic is a little too slippery for me out of the box, and breaking it in just takes a little too long. So let's just get into some first turns. Whoa. Okay, so I'm actually liking this a lot. Even though it looks like a GAN from the outside, it feels like something else. Okay, so it's definitely more controllable. I might have to speed this up and loosen the tensions, but it feels really nice. This might be a contender for my new main. Wait a second. Okay, now I know what this feels like. So this is a Tengyun V2. And I think you can hear that it's a little bit quieter and softer, but they feel really similar. This one has just a little bit less friction, and it's a little bit snappier and louder, which I'm not a huge fan of, but this does have main potential. So besides the feeling of the turns, it's performing very well. I'm not looking up at all, but just to make sure, let's take a look at the corner cutting. So starting off with 45 degrees, no problem, a little more. This cube is a little tight right now, but it's still cutting around that 55 degree mark. Reverse corner cutting, line to line. I'm not surprised that this cube has good reverse corner cutting, especially because the person who made this cube used to design cubes for GAN. Oh yeah, one thing I forgot to mention, since I got the enhanced version, there are also magnets in the edges which attract to magnets in the centerpiece. As you can see in the centerpiece, if you look in the very bottom, you can see that there are 4 tiny magnets, and those are the ones attracting to the edge magnet. Okay, so the only thing left to do is a couple of solves. So I ended up getting a mid 13 second average with this cube, which is pretty much the same exact average I get with my normal main, the Guhong V4. So I think the MS3 V1 does have main potential. I'll probably be setting it up, and I will make a full review on this cube if you guys ask for it in the comments. Thanks for watching, this has been Cubing for Fun, and I'll catch you in the next one.